So I'm FKJ, French Kiwi Juice.
Hi, it's Lovebirds at Dilation.
My name is Khalil.
Hello, I'm Moxie.
We're Behling and SImpson, and this is Dilation in Leeds at the Beaver Factory.
Beaver Works.
Yeah, and it's Brill, Mint and Ace.
I feel like I really enjoy the electronic music scene coming from the UK. Like, people, like famous like electronic bands like Bandax, Disclosure, I really enjoy them. All the UK garage, UK house garage stuff, I'm really into it. And all the post dubstep thing also, like Monkimby. And I feel there's really like a good vibe going there.
Oh, I mean, if you're gonna go like way back to first clubbing experience, maybe like Spiders in Hull, which is some horrible goth venue with, you know, £1 cocktails that you knock you out, and I hated it. And then, I don't know, after that, I don't know if we can say this, but like my first vitamin pill was given to me by Ed, actually, in Manchester back in the day. And yeah, that's kind of, we were just starting to become friends at that point. And I felt very healthy and awake after I've had that vitamin pill. And here we are, you know, a number of years later.
Well, when I was younger, sort of also to do with Bigger Fish, the youth group that I used to DJ for, or that who introduced me to DJing, I used to go to a lot of under 18 raves. So I used to go to Bagley's and Camden Palace, which is now Coco's, of course. So yeah, I was always kind of around that kind of garage scene from when I was younger. So you'd have people like Dizzy Rascal and So Solid, and people like coming and doing live PAs, and EZ and everyone. So that was kind of always a part of like my roots.
Yeah, I think it had a pretty big influence, because in the 90s, Hamburg was the house capital of Germany. There was like a legendary club called The Front. It was a gay club, and it was going on from the mid 80s to the mid 90s. And it was like, you know, they had like Frankie Knuckles, David Morales, everybody was there, and it was really proper underground with a legendary DJ that everybody looked up to. And that was, I think, everybody who was there at that time was influenced by this club and this DJ. So yeah, it kind of, that was my influence on house music.
The guitar was the first instrument I learned. Like, I've played saxophone like at 7 years old, like from 7 to 9, but at that time playing saxophone was more like doing tennis or like judo or football. It was like kind of an experience like this. So like, I did saxophone for 2 years, quit, and then I went to music at 12 years old and really into it, like started composed, and like I said, like started like imitating what I was listening to. And and then I felt like I wanted to learn more, so I learned the piano, like just doing what I was doing at the guitar and just translated to the piano like this. So now I'm more like a piano player now. I really like, piano is my first instrument now.
People like Shorty Blitz, I used to listen to on the radio, and he and people like Mr. Thing have been like big influences to me, and people that have become friends and people that I still look up to. And when they start giving me like good feedback, that's the buzz for me. Like I did a set in Czech Republic for Hip Hop Camp a couple of weeks ago, and like I didn't even notice, but Rodney P and Skits were just there chilling, and then we got there playing back with them, and they were just like, your set was amazing, it was incredible. And for me, as a little kid inside me going, oh my fucking god, Rodney P and Skits love what I'm doing, this is amazing, like, and they just wouldn't shut up about how great it was. And that, things like that are just like, that's quite a big thing for me, personally.
The UK obviously is a country that's really into new music and trends, and all, you know, appreciates music, has a big young crowd who is into music, probably unlike every other country in the world. So, but you know, people like my stuff all over the, everywhere. Not everywhere, but you know.
Yeah, being, you know, coming from NTS and going on to Radio 1 is like a massive step. I mean, there's nothing bigger than the BBC, so it's a massive honour to be able to be asked to join MU DJs, which is a big show. But yeah, I suppose, you know, being on NTS is a bit more freestyle. I just kind of have the tunes that I play and I just kind of get into it. But whereas with Radio 1, you have a production team, everything's kind of, it's a bit more structured and planned, which is great. Like, I love doing both shows. They're both like, you know, like I love doing radio. That's like my passion, like radio and DJing in club. So yeah, it's an honour to be part of Radio 1.
Yeah, I think like I would play like Let's Get It On. That will be the track that would play.
I remember like 10, 15 years ago with my other project, Knee Deep, whenever we had like an absolutely amazing night, like, you know, special night, we used to play Time of My Life from the Dirty Dancing movie. And that was like, we had some absolutely great moments with them.
Venger Boys, I've got a soft spot for the Venger Boys. Boom, 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 boom. I want you in my room. Boom, yeah, and so on and so forth.
What's that Womack and Womack tune? Teardrops. Like, it's such a tune. Like, you kind of got to play that. I always play the Bare Necessities, the Jungle Book. Everyone knows that tune. It's so underrated. Like, everyone knows it. So that's the other one, yeah.
I have a funk band since I'm like 16, and we always do like a couple of shows, even if we don't tour as much as before. And once we have been asked to play like in the trailer of a tractor in like the middle of countryside in front of farmers and all that kind of stuff, and it was like pretty weird and pretty funny, but we enjoyed it so much. It was kind of fun.
The thing with Bristol that makes it like work really well, it's kind of like just a unique mix of factors that work really well. You've got it's a big enough city that there's stuff happening and people want to live there and creative things going on, but it's small enough that you can all get to meet everybody and get to know everyone. It's like near enough London that you can get down there if you need to, but it's far enough away that it's got its own identity.
There's a bit of a community, and it's not based on scenes, it's just a general community. So you end up with situations like, I've been down to nights where someone will be starting off a night or starting off a project or doing their first ever gig, and there'll be only 10 people there, but they're all, you know.
Yeah, one of them's Apple Blim.
Yeah, there'll be like Apple Blim, Pinch, Peverlist, Outbox, Bashmore and Hytale. And that's like, they're the only people there, but everybody comes down to support. And everyone's like, hey,
it's like, it's basically heaven. Your first night is guaranteed to have all those people there. When you move to Bristol, that's part of the contract they signed. They will all turn up to your first gig. Never again, but yeah.